In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet, Congruence, and Triangles. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Our directions for numbers 1 through 6 are to complete each congruence statement by naming the corresponding angle or side. So let's take a look at number 1. Number 1 says that triangle DEF is congruent to triangle KJI, and it says that segment FD is congruent to, well, let's find FD. Side FD, or segment FD, is in the first triangle here. And we can see that it has 3 tick marks. So we're going to locate another segment on the other triangle that also has 3 tick marks. And you can see here we have our 3 tick marks representing that those are indeed congruent. So segment IK is congruent to segment FD. In number 2, it states that triangle BAC is congruent to triangle LMN, and it asks us to find the angle that's congruent to A. So angle A with 2 marks is congruent to angle M, because M also has 2 marks. Moving on to number 3, we have that triangle TUV is congruent to triangle GFE, and we're finding the angle that is congruent to angle U. So here is angle U. You can see that the 2 longer sides connect to form angle U. So the 2 longer sides of GFE connect to form angle F. So angle F is congruent to angle U. Also note, if you look back at number 2, it says that triangle BAC is congruent to triangle LMN. And if we look for angle A, here is A, and M is here. So you can see that in the statement, the triangle BAC is congruent to triangle LMN. They are in the same location. So triangle TUV is indeed congruent to triangle GFE. In number 4, we have triangle WVU is congruent to triangle GHI, and we're looking at angle W. So angle W is here, and again we have the 2 longer sides coming together to form angle W, so the 2 longer sides will come together to form angle G. So angle W is congruent to angle G. And if we look at the positioning in triangle WVU, it's congruent to triangle GHI. The labels are in the same position, both at the front of the statement. In number 5, we have triangle ZXY is congruent to triangle ZXC. And we're given that angle Y is congruent to what? Well, you can see that they are reflections over the segment XZ. So angle Y is going to be congruent to angle C. In number 6, we have triangle DEF is congruent to triangle DSR. Notice that angle D is a vertical angle, so this measure is equal to this measure. We're looking for what angle is congruent to F, and F is this angle here. Line DF is larger than line DE, and line DR is larger than line DS, so you can see that angle R is congruent to angle F. And if you want to look at the positioning, we have DEF congruent to triangle DSR. Moving on to number 7, our directions state to write a statement that indicates that the triangles in each pair are congruent. So remembering how to label, let's say triangle JKI. Triangle JKI is congruent to triangle. Now the positioning of the letters matters. So J is the angle that's congruent to T. So T is going to be the first letter. Angle K is congruent to angle R, so R is the next letter, and angle I is congruent to angle S, so S is the next letter. So our statement is that triangle JKI is congruent to triangle TRS. Let's move on to number 8. Let's order number 8 according to the sides. So we'll do triangle BCD is congruent to BC has 1 tick mark, and CD has two tick marks. So we'll locate the line with one tick mark that follows into the line with two tick marks. So we will order it as triangle GHI. So you can see triangle BCD is congruent to triangle GHI. And I'll stop the video here. Join me in the next video where I'll finish out this worksheet completing numbers 9 through 18. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below and don't forget to click that subscribe button. Subscribing to my channel and liking this video is greatly appreciated. So do that before you move on to the next video.